Afternoon students, last class we last record class we discussed about this. What is this? Only thymus, immune response, lymphoid organs. First we are discuss about the lymphoid organs. So in that lymphoid organ, important one, thymus. What is thymus? The thymus is a flat and bilobed organ located behind the sternum above the heart. Where it is present? Above the heart. So see this picture, they are showing clearly. So above the heart, the thymus is present. See, this is the heart. So up it is, thymus is present, the sternum. Okay, so that place only the thymus is present. Each lobe of thymus contain numerous lobules, number of many lobules present in the thymus. Numerous means number, separated from each other by connective tissue. So it will be separated by the connective tissue. It's called septa. Each lobule is differentiated into two compartments. The outer compartments are outer cortex, densely packed with the immature T cells called thymocytes, whereas the inner compartment is squarely populated with thymocytes. Okay, one of the main secretion in the hormone is thymosin. So thymus secrete one hormone, that hormone name is thymosin. It stimulates the T cell to become mature and immunocompetent. By the early teens, the thymus begins to atrophy and is replaced by the adipose tissue. Thus, thymus is most active during the neonatal and pre-adolescent periods. Okay, next organ is bone marrow. So bone marrow is a lymphoid tissue, so found within the spongy portion of the bone. Bone marrow contains stem cells known as hematopoietic cells. These cells have the potential to multiply through cell division and either remain as stem cells or differentiate and mature into the different kinds of blood cells. Okay, see, this is a cortical bone, spongy bone. The inside only the marrow is there. So bone marrow is very, very important. So if you are getting mutton, you can chewing this in bone, big bone is present in that in Tamil we call it as a nalli elumbu. So that is only inside what we are in, the black color is then that we are suck that is only we call it as a bone marrow. Okay, so up having no that big size, that is bone marrow. It is very, very important for our immunology or immunity. Okay, the cell have the potential to multiply through the cell division and either remain as stem cells or differentiate and mature into the different kinds of blood cells. Okay, next, secondary and peripheral lymphoid organs. These secondary peripheral lymphoid organs, antigen is localized so that it can be effectively exposed to mature lymphocytes. Okay, so see, this is the picture, mature lymphocytes. So thymus where it is present, and diaphragm is there, and here down it is groin. It's a groin is present. So this only secondary peripheral organ. So ampride and lymph nodes and spleen, and that lymph nodes, if everything is present, that Peyer patches, that is the tonsils of the intestines. Okay, found in the wall of the small intestine. Peyer patch where it is present, it's present in small intestine. It is also captured all the bacteria, whatever bacteria enter in our body, it will be captured, especially in the intestine. It kill that. So it is also act a immunity power for us. Okay, see, stomach, this is a spleen. Spleen is also, and that our mouth, and that under the tongue, so it is also lingual tonsil, palatal tonsil, adenoids, opening of the eustachian tube. These and all secondary lymphoid organs. It is also act the lymphoid organ. Okay, this, see, this is obstruction of that. This is a descending colon. Each one by colon is there. So appendix, it is not a way present in that, but appendix is an organ. It is not act that, but it is it is what any damage remains, it will be changed into the poisons, but it is not useful. This organ didn't have any work at all. Next, Peyer patch, tonsil of the intestine, found in the wall of the small intestine, capture and destroy bacteria, I already told. The best examples of lymph nodes, appendix, Peyer patches of gastrointestinal tract, tonsil, adenoids, spleens, mucosal associated lymphatics, that is MALT, that is a full form of mucosal associated lymphoid tissue, GALT, gut associated lymphoid tissue, BALT, bronchial trachea associated lymphoid tissue. These are the very, very important organ for our body system. What is the Peyer patch? It is an oval shaped area and thickened in the tissue and embedded in the mucus secreting lining of the small intestine. Where it is present? Small intestine. How the saliva is there? Like that, in one secretion, the mucus. And that mucus is helpful for all the vertebrate animals. It kills the microorganism or the macrophages. So it is present in T cells and P cells. Next, the tonsil are a pair of soft tissue masses located at the back of the throat. Where it is present? Throat. It is called as pharynx. The tonsils are part of the lymphoid system which help to fight infection, the stop invading germs including bacteria and virus. Next, spleen is the secondary lymphoid organ located in the upper part of the abdominal cavity close to the diaphragm. Spleen contain B and T cell. It being humoral and cell mediated immunity. Next, mucus associated lymphoid tissue. What is MALT is a diffuse system of a small concentration of lymphoid tissue in the alimentary canal, respiratory canal and urinary genital tracts. These place and all the mucus is present. Sorry, MALT is present. That is mucus associated lymphoid tissue. MALT is very popular in the lymphocytes. Where is it? That our basal cell. Such as what are they? T and P cells. As well as plasma cell and macrophages, each of which is well situated in the encounter antigen and passing through the mucosal epithelium. Where it is present in all the bacteria, it will be kill all the macrophages. Okay, gut associated lymphoid tissue is component of the mucus associated lymphoid tissue which work in the immune system to protect the body from the invasion in the gut. The bronchus associated lymphoid tissue, also component of MALT, is made of the lymphoid tissue. So GALT, BALT, MALT, everything it is helpful for the lymph nodes only. It is only where it is present and what it will be do, only it is killing the microorganism. Okay, so where it is present, the BALT, bronchus, so it is present in our lungs only, respiratory track. Okay, various subsequent membrane site of the body such as gastrointestinal tract is there, nasopharynx, and this is present in our nasal place, and that is thyroid and breast, lung, salivary glands, eyes and skin. These are all submucosal membrane. Okay, gut associated lymphoid is, that is gall protector, gastrointestinal tract, that is our intestinal tract, and for example BALT is our nasopharyngeal duct. That is means it is a helpful for whatever foreign it will be attacked from us, it will be help for BALT. Okay, BALT, where it is a naso means our respiratory tract. So GALT is G for gut. So G, it is a gastrointestinal. B for bronchitis. So lungs places it will be help for us. Okay, are you understand clearly that MALT is salivary gland. Thank you students. Next class we will see in the lymph nodes.